Hi YouTubers, so how are you today? So let's go ahead and let's get a lot of things out of the way. Let's talk about the Oculus Quest today. It's ups, it's downs, it's highs, it's lows, overpriced behavior. So I'm gonna grab my lovely cup of coffee here, my lovely animal mug, and we're going to talk about the Oculus Quest. One second. Everybody's got to have their patent pending furry sloth. Ah, good coffee. All right, ladies and gentlemen, so let's go ahead and talk about the Oculus Quest. I have been spending the last few days in the Oculus Quest. I can give you the pluses and the minuses of the device itself. The pluses: I love the controllers, I love how well they track, and I absolutely love the device itself. This video is not sponsored or endorsed in any way by Oculus. See, I like doing a real review, not a I'm getting paid by Oculus review. Okay? And that is what I always like to do on my channel to warn families that are going to be buying this, or to warn teenagers that are going to be buying this. In this case, mostly teens, because that's what this is designed for. I would not give this to a child. Do not. So let's go ahead and let's talk about the Oculus Quest and where I feel that this thing is good, bad, and the ugly. Let's start with the controllers. So let me go over here and grab one of my controllers, please. And we will, Oh, well, you know, I hooked one of my controllers. One second, ladies and gentlemen. Oh, man. One second, ladies and gentlemen. I would seem to be having a little bit of a temperamental issue. Great, I got an Oculus controller wrapped around my dang freaking. There we go. I got them wrapped around the dang seat. That was interesting, ladies and gentlemen. Alright. Now, back to where I was so rudely interrupted. Let's start with the Oculus controllers. And let's get rocking and rolling there, shall we? So, we're talking about the controllers. Now, I love these controllers. These work great. They track good. Nice controllers, good design. I have some qualms with them. First off, you put a nice rubber grip on the bottom, but you put no rubber grip on the top. This creates a huge problem for this battery cover, because as you're playing hot and vigorous games, you slide the battery cover off and your battery cover keeps coming off. And the reason it keeps coming off, these are magnetic, which also is a problem and a nuisance. But good controllers. I like these because I can literally just pick them up, ready to go. I can go in, I can zoom, I can move, I can do everything I need to do, and I can sit here and kick ass with these controllers. Nice job, Oculus. These get a thumbs up from me. In fact, I wish that somebody would figure out how to hack these controllers to use in emulators. I think emulators would work awesome with this with a Windows PC, especially since these are Bluetooth, essentially. I wonder if somebody could get these to work for controllers in, like, a emulator for PC. Can you imagine playing, you know, anything with this? It would be really cool just sitting here, hey, look, left, right, trigger, hey, fire, yay, woohoo, analog sticks. You know, your basic controls are all here, so this would be a cool thing to even figure out how to get to work on Windows. Love these. Now, let's get into headsets. Oh, boy. This is where things start getting weird. Let's go ahead and talk about the headset. What I like about my headset and what I dislike about the headset. Okay? So, The first thing is, I love this headset. I think great idea, Oculus. Good job on this. Really cool idea. Tracks really well. Here's what I don't like. When I'm streaming, I want to be able to stream to other streaming services. Now, don't get me wrong, ladies and gentlemen, I do understand that this is a device made by Facebook, for Facebook, powered by Facebook, blah, blah, blah. The streaming features in this only stream to Facebook. But I would like streaming to Twitch. I'd like streaming to YouTube. I'd like streaming to so many other sites, because that is the one thing that Oculus is disconnecting from hugely with its audience base, is streaming services. We want to be able to stream to more than one platform, and we can't. We can only stream to Facebook. And it gets even trickier to stream, because you have to actually wear a gaming headset in order to stream to Facebook. Yeah, you heard me right. You have to plug in headphones into this. If you don't, you get no in-game audio when streaming to Facebook. So that's another problem I have. Why do I have to wear a pair of headphones to do this? Now, this is where things get nutty. And let me show you how nutty I look in this thing with a pair of gaming headphones. Now, this is a set of cheap gaming headphones you can get anywhere. Now, one of the features of this headset, which is cool, is it has something that I like, which is it has an experimental feature called Bluetooth keyboard and mouse. Now, when I get done, who do you think I'm gonna look like when I wear this? Come on. Epic Rap Battles did the thing on him. I am literally gonna look like Stevie Wonder. I crap you not, because one of the experimental features of this headset is keyboard and mouse. Now think about this. I've got the headset on. Hi, YouTubers. I've got the earphones on. Hey, YouTubers. Now I got a keyboard and mouse in front of me. Do I look like a dumbass or what? I mean, really? Can we get a better pair of earphones for these except the in-the-ear piles of garbage that Oculus sells? The in-the-ear earphones only work when you have one good ear that works. So, see, I only have one ear that I can wear the earbud in. And you need two earbuds in order for their surround sound feature to work. Yes, there is a headphone jack here and a headphone jack here on both sides. So you have to run two separate headphones to here. Can we please get some real headphones? I just want a real pair of headphones. Please, even if I have to make my own, I don't care. Or if I have to buy a pair and modify them, I'll buy the pair, I'll modify them, and I'll build them myself. I want a lightweight pair of headphones that fit this damn thing. Not this gaming headset piece of crap that weighs 40 pounds on my head. We need some real headphones, not some in-the-ear garbage. Thank you. The keyboard and mouse feature, though, in experimental features, is really stupid. Because how are you going to see the keyboard to type from? And worst of all, how are you going to see the mouse if you can't even see outside of this headset? Really makes you think. So now I thought that's just freaking hilarious. Think about that now. You're wearing the headphones, you're wearing the earpiece, and they want you to see a keyboard and mouse. Really? Really? Who the heck wants keyboard and mouse in a bloody VR headset? I thought the idea was VR. Oh my God, really? The biggest qualm I have with the Oculus Rifts so far, and the Oculus Quest and the Oculus Go, has been the Oculus Store. Now let's go ahead and talk about why this is a royal pain in the keister. Oculus Store. Hi, Moss in the Oculus Store is $29.99 with the Enchanted Garden. Hi, Moss is $9.99 on the PlayStation 4 store. And that's it. Now, where do I want to buy Moss from? I'm not going to buy it on Oculus. I'm going to buy it on my PlayStation VR. Stupid! Lower the price tag. This is getting ridiculous. And in other countries, it's even more money. In some countries, Moss is $46 for a game on the Oculus Quest. That's nuts. That's insane. Then I started seeing other things. There are some really cool, unique features in the Oculus Quest that I absolutely think are marvelous freebies that you don't even have to buy anything to deal with. And that is, and this is going to really shock you when I say this, VR chat. There's another new VR chat called Eclipse, or I think it's Eclipse or something. There's a few VR chat services in there. There's VR chat, Eclipse VR, I think it's called, and another VR chat service as well. There's also Rec Room. The common basic, you know, things that you want in a Quest. Cool. Love that. There's YouTube VR. Love it. There's Netflix, but no Netflix VR. Now, that's the weird one. So the Oculus Go has Netflix VR. The Oculus Quest doesn't. So I'm like, that's kind of odd. Because why does Netflix VR work in one headset, but doesn't work in the other headset? That doesn't make any sense. And then it's like, you've got your freebies, your free edumacation software. And we call it the free edumacation software because it is. It's those free education software to get you used to using the controllers and to teach you about history. One of the ones that I really liked that really I can understand why people gave it such high regard and reviews is the Anne Frank House VR. I do recommend downloading that one, and that's cool because of the interactivity that's in it. You can actually open doors in it, literally look around the corner, look down hallways, literally explore the space you're in. It's a great way to get used to walking in a VR headset. Love that idea, and it's also a really cool piece of history to hear parts and pieces from these, from the diary. It's really an amazing and emotional piece that is really beautiful and very well done. The International Space Station one, however, will make you throw up. And it's basically flat out because of motion sickness. And because of the fact that it's a space simulation, you literally are going to go and run for the nearest thing to go puke. Not cool, but, you know, it's expected. And then there's a lot of other cool things that you can do. One that I really found that really ticked me off that I'm glad was a freebie, sort of, is Biobab's Bonfire. And here's why. First, I'm glad I didn't have to buy it. So Biobab, creators of Invasion and Crow the Legend, which were freebies, decided to do their first charge for 15-minute movie. Yes, you just heard me right. They're charging you $5 for a 15-minute movie that basically should have been free, entitled Bonfire. And this thing should literally be thrown in a bonfire. I'm not impressed. It's not the greatest experience in the world, but there's a plus side to it. Oculus gave me $5 free store credit, so I'm like, okay, you're giving me free $5 store credit, so I'll buy it for that, because A, it's free, B, I didn't have to pay for it, C, it's your money. Haha, thank you for that one, Oculus. But it wasn't a bad experience. I just wouldn't pay $5 for it. And there are so many other great experiences that you can do with the Oculus Quest that I would recommend besides Oculus Link. So honestly, and in all due aspect, I highly recommend this. I really think that this is an amazing headset and will offer more features as it progresses. And one of the things that we're supposed to be getting next year is hand tracking, which means no controllers. So this will be cool to see. So this is basically my review of the Oculus Quest. It's good, it's bad, it's ugly, but it's fun. Thank you.